Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP. Today I'm dueling with my Painting Guardian build and I parried this spinning guy. I did this Painting Guardian build just because I like Painting Guardians and I thought of making an example of how to use the Monastery Scimitar right, and believe me, it's an awesome weapon as main weapon, not as a parry spam thing. For parries you can use the Scimitar. And yeah, the Scimitar is also kinda OP since the last few patches, and yeah, it is what it is. And you see the spinning double hit, which is at low poise almost a sure hit. And if you chain it and do the second one hand R2, you get a 4-hit combo. You will see this here in a few fights later. And it's an awesome weapon. The damage output is great, and this guy uses it in the offhand, and this range is kinda buggy, I think. So here I dueled him again and thought like, get off! I don't want you! Alright, here I'm fighting against this guy using the curved dragon greatsword thing, and you see this spinning around, woohoo! This was the 4-hit. This cuffed dragon greatsword is overused in PvP. I tested it, it is an amazing weapon, but most people overuse it. And buffed, its damage is ridiculous. Also, for cosplaying a Painting Guardian, and that I don't... That I am not believed to be a complete dumbass and parry spamming monastery, I have in my offhand the bandit knife and a normal scimitar, so that I don't that people don't think me of parrying with the monastery. But the normal scimitar is OP enough for parrying, so there. And here, I kinda swapped around what weapons I use here, the Melu Scimitar, and yeah, it went out to be very fun cosplaying as a Painting Guardian. In the beginning here, I didn't have the leggings of the Painting Guardian, so I used the one closest to the leggings, being Hide Knight leggings, and Yeah, it's just how it is. Here I got a guard break, a face slap guard break, Falcon Punch, and yeah, the R1, the one-handed R2, is it, of the scimitar, I keep saying scimitar, of the scimitar, looks so cool, just like pro encountering the opponent with just a cool swing up in the air. And it is chained into the normal running attack move, the double hit to the floor, and it can be a 3-hit stunlock. Also, the Monastery Scimitar, when two-handed and R2'd, has a pretty damaging 2-hit combo if you hit it, because the great disadvantage of the monastery and the thing that balances it as an attacking weapon is that it is pretty short. Its parry, its hitbox is kinda bullshit. You have to kiss your opponent to hit with this, and this guy playing okay, not complete scummy, with his Red Rust scimitar, and in the end wrecking me. And that's because the Red Rust Scimitar is pretty damaging. Pretty damn damaging. Also, like you see, I used the White Ring. Some people no-note at me and thought I wanted to fool them and leading them into a trap or so, I think. But in the end I just did it for aesthetics, because the painting guardians are white, and yeah, you saw this void stunlock took 80% of his health. Yeah. Also a big advantage of this setup and this build is that you can pretty damn good wreck ganks and hackers, because you all even if you don't have the monastery as left hand weapon, you can still parry with it if you two-hand it and press L2. So if you meet a gank and you need to pull out those parries, just take a two-hand and parry. You always get, you most time get the monastery scimitar parry attempt. And yeah, that's it. Also, what did I want to say? Yeah, the repose damage of the monastery scimitar is quite fine. It is very good, it can wreck people, and it mostly takes over 50% of their health, so it's cool. And this setup, the normal scummy setup. Yeah, oh, not really the normal scummy setup, being hovels and chesters and monastery and a buffed up weapon and all other buffs that you could apply. He is using buffed up weapon, jesters, no huffles and no monastery for parrying, but he uses the warped sword, which is also OP for parrying, and the warped sword damage output is ridiculous. Also, I played with dual bandit knives, dual wielding, and what the fuck is going on with the damage of the bandit knife? I literally did no damage at all, even if hitting with both at the same time and infusing them. You saw that? Yeah, in the end I swapped the bandit knife dual wield for scimitar dual wields, and which worked out better than this that I did there. And this guy, using a big weapon is always fun to fight against, and even if they are using the one and only Gurm Great Axe, which is kinda overused, since you saw that 4-hit combo and almost did the same damage like the normal R1 of the scimitar of the monastery. Look at that backstep damage, it's also fine. So definitely amazing weapon if you use it as a normal weapon. Double kill. That was an awesome kill. Just back hopping into his roll attack and then doing the spin attack. I could have done an R1, would have been faster, but that 4-hit combo, oh my god. I definitely understand people who heal against such a 4-hit combo, because that's ridiculous. Yeah. And this guy, typical mage with jesters. I didn't bother to try to parry him there, because I even had in my left hand the thing. Yes, exactly that. Ouch, that hit me. Yeah. Also a disadvantage of the monastery, 4-hit swing is, or 2-hit swing is, it leaves you pretty damn vulnerable. It's just, run away, come on, run away and heal, come. You were supposed to run away and heal, what's up with you? You already have a monastery in your left hand, so why don't you heal? It's, yeah, I just waited for him to spam, to spam or to hit the parry button there so I could attack him. And in the end he casts it too near in front of me, so that I could wreck him pretty hard. Yeah. There will be a second part of this Duel Links with the Monastery. It's gonna be uploaded at some day, somewhere in the future. This guy running around now and jumping off. What the fuck? Well, yeah, this guy, typical magic user, spamming the Dark Fog. But he didn't. He did do the spam all the time, and I spinned right into it. Got lucky there that he didn't poison me, but he did poison me in the end. Yeah, I took a green moss thing, poison moss, there. Oh, yeah, rapier spam. It's the S-Dog, right? Of course it's the S-Dog. Why shouldn't it be the S-Dog? And backstab. So, thank you all for watching this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe, like and favorite everything you want. And I see you all in the next one.